Hello students, welcome to Flip Learn's NEET test preparation classes. So today the topic our discussion would be cell cycle. As you can see over the board, cell cycle is one of the major important topic from which every time NEET questions are being asked. So I have given you just a brief review about it. So let's go forward with this. If you can see this cell cycle is basically divided into two phases, that is your interphase and your M phase. M phase is the one which has been categorized further into your mitosis and meiosis. Mitosis is your equationary division and meiosis is your reductional division. If you see further, this mitosis has been subdivided into your further stages, which is your prophase, metaphase, anaphase and your telophase. Before we go ahead and take care of the cell cycle, I want you guys to look here with interphase. Interphase is that phase of cell cycle which occupies 95% of the cell growth cycle stage. What do I mean by this is that during interphase, majority of the time the cell is preparing itself in order to further undergo cell division. So interphase is divided into your G1 phase, S phase and G2 phase. If you would see, I have separately drawn a G0 phase. G0 phase is a phase which is actually known as your quiescent phase. When I say quiescent phase, say for example if a tissue undergoes injury or it meets some unfavorable conditions. So when it goes to G1 phase, when any cell is dividing in G1 phase under unfavorable conditions, it will not enter S phase. In fact, it will immediately go to a dormant stage which is known as G0 stage. Okay, so let's quickly look into the diagram here. If you would see, I have summarized it here for you. There is G1 phase, and yes, after G1 itself will go S phase, G2 phase, and then if you can see here, this is actually your M phase. Here the nucleus or a nuclear division occurs, followed by cytokinesis, which is your cytoplasmic division. And this complete stage is actually known as your, along with this. If I would say, I need to draw it with dotted line because it has to be under unfavorable conditions. This will be unfavorable. This complete is known as interphase. And when I say M phase, that means this one is your mitosis or it could be meiosis also. And with this cytokinesis, it will become complete M phase. So this was a brief review about cell cycle. The thing that I have just taught you, let's go ahead with a certain small clip of animation.
The interphase and mitosis. The interphase is the period during which a cell appears to be resting, but in reality, it undergoes a period of rigorous activity. During this phase, the cell not only grows, but also prepares for DNA synthesis and cell division. On the other hand, during the mitosis phase, the cell undergoes a nuclear division followed by cytokinesis. Therefore, during each cell cycle, a cell duplicates not only its genome, but also all the other cell organelles and macromolecules. The cell cycle begins with the interphase, which can be divided into two gap phases, G1 and G2, with an S phase in between. Therefore, in all, each cell cycle can be divided into four phases. The cell growth phase or gap phase G1, the synthesis phase S, the second growth phase G2, and the mitosis phase. Looking at a new cell cycle, a cell enters the first growth phase G1 when it senses growth factors. During the G1 phase, new protein synthesis occurs and the cell enlarges as all cellular components are duplicated. After a few hours in the jivan phase, the cell crosses the point of no return or commitment point and gets committed to divide. However, if the conditions are unfavorable for cell division, the cell may enter a G0 phase, which may last from a few hours to a lifetime. G0 is a resting phase during which a cell rests. When favorable conditions return, the cell re-enters the cell cycle and reaches the commitment point and gets committed to DNA replication. Once committed, a cell undergoes DNA replication even if favorable conditions are removed.
The video or animation regarding what we have done so far. So just have a question regarding the same. If you would look at the question here, it says that the replication of nuclear DNA occurs in or during. So let me write it down for you. First one is your G1 phase. I'm just going to write down each individual answers here. If I would say the nuclear DNA replication happens in S phase. Nuclear DNA replication happens in S phase. What about G1 phase? G1 is the phase where maximum preparation happens. That means cell is undergoing cell growth. Cell growth is happening. G2 is the one in which, again, when I talk about G1, it goes to S phase. Then it goes to G2 phase, where maximum protein synthesis happens. G0 phase, also known as quiescent phase, which we have already discussed. So from this question, you can make it out that there might be numerous questions which could be asked. So students, this is all for today. We would be learning this application-based method of study, ensuring your success in NEET. Thank you so much.